Welcome to another Wildflower Moment, brought to you by the Florida Wildflower Foundation. Come with me and we'll explore one more Wildflower of the Moment. Goldenrod is one of the easiest and showiest fall-blooming wildflowers to grow throughout Florida. If you're gardening for wildlife, this plant is a must-have. Goldenrods have been used medicinally since Roman times or earlier, and seaside goldenrod was used by the Seminoles to treat wounds. Seaside goldenrod is generally the most available of the four native goldenrods that are grown commercially, and we'll talk about all four. This plant blooms in very showy masses on dunes, in swales and brackish marshes, on sandy soils and coastal areas, and occasionally inland throughout the state, except for the Keys. This plant performs best in harsh conditions with no watering after establishment. And to reduce its height, you'll want to cut the plants back in midsummer before blooms start to form, and cut back to basal rosettes after blooming. There's no need for cold protection. Seaside goldenrod also is fairly disease-free. This should all be music to any gardener's ears. I'm not worried about allergies, because I know that this is goldenrod, not ragweed. Ragweed is the source of allergens for a lot of people, but goldenrod absolutely is not. So this is a good plant to put in your garden for a myriad of pollinators, from bees to butterflies to wasps. Yes, they are pollinators too. So add this to your garden and don't worry about the allergies at all. Seaside goldenrod has gold and yellow tubular blooms that densely cover the long wand-like inflorescences on the tips of the stem in summer and fall in most of the state, and also in spring in South Florida. This perennial retains its leaves year-round, and plants are 4 to 6 feet tall in flower and spread by rhizomes to make large colonies over time. Plant it where it can make a big show in the garden, or allow it a large space in the landscape. This plant needs lots of sun to bloom prolifically, but seaside goldenrod will tolerate some shade. Although it can occur in moist to wet areas naturally, it's important to plant it in sandy, well-drained soils for best performance in landscapes. This keeps its height in check, keeps plants from falling over or need staking, and produces more showy blooms. Seaside goldenrod is also salt tolerant. Now for the other species of goldenrod. Wand goldenrod, Solidago stricta, blooms in the fall with lavender blazing stars in wetter flatwoods and prairie communities throughout Florida. It has the same slender wand appearance of the blazing star, but its flowers are golden yellow and reach 2 to 4 feet. Pine barren goldenrod, Solidago fistulosa, is Florida's most common goldenrod, found on disturbed sites and in pine flatwoods, wetter soils, and dry upland habitats throughout Florida. Its golden flowering heads are found on the ends of stems reaching 3 to 5 feet. Lastly, Chapman's goldenrod. It likes the dry, sandy soils of sandhills and open hammocks. It does not spread by rhizomes and is a relatively slender branching plant that reaches 3 to 4 feet tall, shorter than most other species. So you'll see that regardless of what your requirements are in your own garden, there is a goldenrod for you. Plant it and see the pollinators flock to your yard. We hope you give it a shot. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to see more Wildflower Moments like this and even more content you're gonna love.